show you how you set up a long InDesign document. Now please bear in mind I'm not an InDesign expert here, and this has been information and stuff gleaned mostly from the internet in the last week or so. So it's going to be a wee bit rusty, but bear with me. Okay, so we've got InDesign loaded. First screen that you see is the what do you want to do? Do you want to create a new document or a new book? And we'll just go for a new document just now. Okay, it's asking us for size and orientation for the document. So we'll change the document size. We're going to do one that's say a little kind of pamphlet type thing. Say it's 150mm by 150mm. You know, you want it to do something that's fairly kind of designy. Okay, so we'll set that up like that, and we're going to have no margins here. You want it to try and print to the edge of the page, so we'll make the margin zero throughout the document. Now the bleed is a kind of an area of that gives the people, whoever's cutting it out, a bit of a chance to actually get it cut out. Allows for a bit of inaccuracy. So you might allow a bleed of maybe just a millimeter all the way around the document. The slug is an area where you can kind of put notes to the printer and these kind of things, and then around the document, and you probably wouldn't need that in this instance. Okay, but the bleed's probably advisable. Okay, so this first section is really just on the setup of the document. So we can see here the page. Here I'll just zoom out a wee bit so we can see what's happening. Just bring it across. Okay, if we want to print on both sides of the paper, then you need facing and the rear pages as well. So what we want to do is define how each page works. So we're going to design a master for the facing page and the opposite page. So let's take this one at a time. And bear in mind, you've got to do this to both sides if you want them both to look the same. So we'll bring in some margins first. So the margins are set to the very edge of the paper. What we're going to do is bring in a few guides for maybe positioning text and keeping away from the middle of the document. So where it gets bound, you don't want your pictures kind of disappearing into the binding necessarily. Well, you could do, I suppose. Okay, so we'll drag a guide on here, and I'm going to put this guide at say the 125mm mark. Okay. Let's put another guide in, maybe at the 25mm mark, so you bring it in and then reposition it. Okay, I'm going to pull one down from the top, just 5mm, so if I've got some text, I don't want the text to actually go to the edge of the page, but pictures, you could do. Okay, let's have one down further, let's say the 100mm mark. I'll put one at 105, so I create a bit of space between the text and the pictures if it's there, and that'll do. Just, you know, this could be, it's obviously to your design. So that's the master for that page. We now have to do the same, but on the opposite side, for the other side of the page. So hopefully we can see those, so we can get a good idea. Let's do the top ones first. This one was at 5mm. Then had one at 100. Then one at 105, and I didn't have any more horizontals, but I did have verticals, so this one will be at 175, because it's 150 to the middle of the page. Where'd he go? I think it's there. Did I type 150 there? I think I must have typed 150. 175, that's better. And then the final one was 25mm in from the other side, so that should put it at 275. Okay, so with a bit, it's a bit of a problem with this, the screen for the Camtasia, that you don't have much space to play with. But that's the two master pages set up. Actually, I will put a margin in at the bottom. I'll put in an area at the bottom because I want to put my page numbers in down at the bottom. So I'm dragging one down there. Let's put that, I say, at 140. And then on this master, another one at 140 as well. Now that one didn't come in as a guide, did it? Make sure it's on the page. Okay. And 140 for that. Okay, so that's the page basically formatted. Now I'm not doing, you know, contents pages and like, that'll come later on. What we're going to do is create a book and put each of our chapters into that book. So this is actually the design for a chapter, not necessarily the whole document. Okay, but it could be the whole document, so it's really up to you.